Saturday. And the temperature is 100 degrees out. Unbelievable. And they're cutting down my shade for the morning sun, so I'm going to lose that, a little bit of it. But, oh well. The plants are loving it. This little guy, you know, was actually kind of smaller. I was going to say dwarf, but not really. And boy, he just loves the heat now. You just throw a little water in him and he grows. Sometimes, you know, Christians, we as Christians, grow better in adversity than we do in prosperity, because it brings our dependency back in right relationship with God, that we become less independent and more aware of our need and the necessity of having a personal relationship with God, because anybody can read the Bible and interpret it any way they want to. They really can. I mean, there's lots of ideas out there that are all over the internet, but all over people's imagination too, and they create every day something new and come up with some wild idea that they say is in the Bible. And technically, they're right. It is in the Bible, but it may not be of the Bible. Because you can claim that something is there if you take it out of context and you don't use the volume of the book to speak for itself or to answer as God would speak to us through it. So, in some ways, they're right. But in one way, they're completely wrong, because the Bible was never meant to be as a source point only of the example of truth, but as an interpersonal relationshipal type of communication device that God used to cause us to be in a right relationship with Him, so that we could hear His voice as we read it, as we study it, as we apply it to our lives. And likewise also, He would eventually speak to us direct in a still small voice. So be careful, be mindful, be aware that there are people out there that claim lots of things, but your personal relationship with God is what Jesus came to give you. And you need to have that assured, reassured, and the way that you do that is by reading the volume of Scripture. And in devotionals, that helps point us in the direction to the Scriptures and reminds us to be full of the Word of God. So that way we would recognize when God speaks to us His voice. Then was Jesus led up by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. In the days of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and supplications with strong crying and tears unto him that was able to save him from death, and was heard in that he feared, though he were a son, yet learned he obedience by the things which he suffered. And being made perfect, he became the author of eternal salvation unto all them that obey him. We have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities, but was in all points tempted, like as we are, yet without sin. There hath no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. But God is faithful, who will not suffer you to be tempted above that you are able, but will, with the temptation, also make a way to escape, that you be able to bear it. My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. You know, that's what's so reassuring about knowing who we know and who we love, because He was tempted even as you are and as I am, and He did live, He did exist, He did have a life, He did have cares, worries, anxieties, fears, troubles, but He had choices with which we are given the same choices to make. He turned them over to His Father in heaven. He looked to God every day. He asked the Holy Spirit to guide him, and he was filled with that Holy Spirit so that he would be empowered to not sin. And in our lives, we may not be quite so filled, but though, because we do sin, but we are able to walk as he walked and learn more from his example than any other man that lived, because not only was he the Son of Man, he was the Son of God. The Son of Man came to give his life a ransom for many. If the blood of bulls and goats and the ashes of a heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctifies to the purifying of the flesh, How much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter. I lay down my life for the sheep. No man takes it from me, but I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. The life of the flesh is in the blood, and I have given it to you upon the altar, to make an atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that makes an atonement for the soul. Without the shedding of blood, there is no remission. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Much more then, being now justified by his blood, we shall be saved from wrath through him. Isn't that what we all want, to be saved from wrath? And Jesus has taken care of it. Our choice is, do we want to have a relationship with him? And do we want to maintain that relationship to him? Sin separates. So if you sin, ask God for forgiveness, and your relationship with Jesus is restored. There's only one reason why. Because he loves you.